Bonsoir Perpignan. C'est un grand plaisir d'être ici ce soir au nom du Comité international de la Croix-Rouge et de la Fondation Sanofi Espoir. Cela fait 2 ans successivement que le prix est remis à un photo-reportage qui s'est déroulé en Syrie. Ça n'est pas un hasard. Encore une fois, on souhaiterait faire un hommage aux reporters, aux photographes qui nous a formidablement convaincus par sa maturité, son travail, sa vision, son œil, et qui nous a donné un témoignage supplémentaire sur ce qui se passe en Syrie actuellement. Merci beaucoup.
Merci. Et donc, le check. Thank you very much. Thank you for having us tonight. Special thanks to International Red Cross, obviously Sanofi Espoir, and SIPA Press. And special thanks to Jonathan Weld, if he's around.
But, yeah. He is.
He is. All right.
Merci, Sébastien. Merci à vous.
Hi, my name is Sébastien Ontomada, and I'm a contributor for SIPA Press, and we have the International Red Cross show back here from my work inside Syria. You know, reporters or journalists always go to the front line or then trying to cover the actual bang bang and see how, you know, armies move, advance or lose ground. I mean, this is a general idea of what, you know, conflict really is, but I just think it was starting to become extremely redundant to cover, you know, the actual fight. And it just happened that I turned my camera around and started experiencing a different reality and something that I had never really, you know, covered in other wars. And I became kind of close friends with some doctors and people that worked at the hospitals. And we started creating this kind of really great relationship where they would show me around, that they were actually asking for my support and saying, please come and see what we're doing, you know. In Aleppo, you know, makeshift is the term that describes what the situation was there on the ground on a medical perspective. And, you know, you had a bigger hospital, which was the Dar al-Shifa, that later got bombed. And they started, you know, splitting up hospitals throughout the city, you know, in people's houses, in people's basements, in order to make sure that disaster of being targeted, you know, would not necessarily happen again. I mean, it's crazy that wounded people are being taken out of a hospital, you know, by hand with all their equipment on them, because there are no facilities, there's no equipment, you know, and these bodies are being brought from one makeshift hospital to another because they get filled up very fast. And some of them, you know, the ones that are in the most precarious situation are brought to Turkey because they cannot, you know, be cured in the proper way inside of the city of Aleppo. So for me, it was just a constant shock to see, you know, people on the ground being treated, blood, you know, stepping on blood, needles being reused. I mean, it's a pure guerrilla response or guerrilla warfare, and everybody's making the possible they can on the ground.